going to come down those staircases in a processional. You will hear me announce the teacher, so that if you want to get your cameras ready for a Kodak moment, you'll be prepared. Once again, please welcome Miss Jones and the fifth grade gifted students. now Miss Ivy's class, please.
Get it.
Perfect graders.
Ceremonies. Here is Sanaya Mojica with the Pledge of Allegiance. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands.
It is my privilege to introduce Khalid Bryant with the welcome.
To Dr. Jackson, our esteemed principal, Dr. Midas, our assistant principal, teachers, staff, parents, and fellow students, good morning. It is an honor and a privilege to welcome you to the Brentwood Elementary School 2014-2015 5th Grade Awards Ceremony. We appreciate that so many of you made the time in your busy schedules to share a few moments with us. This is an important time in our lives, and your presence here today adds to the significance of this occasion. Today marks the start of a new chapter in our lives, a new beginning. We have had many experiences here at Brentwood. We have learned so much, and our lives have been enriched throughout the years we have spent here at Brentwood, our home away from home. Today, many of us will receive awards for our accomplishments. To those who will earn these awards, we congratulate you and hope that you will continue to do work. To those who unfortunately will not be earning any awards today, we say, keep trying and never ever stop, because if you can dream it, then you can achieve it. We can all be proud that we have completed this important first step on the ladder of education. Reach for tomorrow through education. This step is the beginning. So please sit back, enjoy the program, and thank you for coming.
Thank you, Khalid. And now I'd like to introduce our esteemed principal, Dr. Sharon D. Jackson, with the privilege of presenting the awards to the valedictorian, highest honor student, and the salutatorian honor student, and our general students for 2015.
Teachers have to tell me what to do. I just work here. Let me just, again, good morning and welcome fifth grade parents and siblings. Please, let's give a round of applause to these wonderful fifth grade students. Your boys and girls, they've worked very hard this year. This was a new year for Brentwood, as you know, due to the reading proficiency and the requirements with the state and the Department of Education. Brentwood was an extended day school, so we were in school an hour longer. And that was a lot for the boys and girls, as well as the teachers and everyone else, but they worked very hard. And I'm so proud of them. I can't tell you how much it gives us a lot of joy to see them go through the transition and the rites of passage, so to speak, to move on to middle school. Everything wasn't perfect. There were struggles and barriers, but they've come. They're here. They're successful. They've moved on, and they're growing, and they'll become better citizens in our community. Although the city of Miami Gardens may be, perceived as an area of high crime, I disagree. I think the city of Miami Gardens is a great city. Yes, there is crime, but it is not the worst. Crime is higher on the beach. But because the beach is a high tourist area, the notoriety is minimized. So those of you who are homeowners or residents, or just remember that we make our city what it is. And I give you kudos to fight to make this a fair and comfortable city. The mayor was here, and he met with some of the fifth graders, and he was awesome. I hadn't had the pleasure of talking to him one-to-one, and he also went to school with some of our teachers, Ms. Walker, Ms. Jones. So it was really nice to have Mayor Gilbert here. He promised to donate headphones. Do you know, what day was that he came on? Wednesday, I think it was that Friday or Monday, he personally brought the headphones. So I thought that was impressive, because We have many elected officials who make promises to us when they're being reelected and we never see them again. So I gave him a lot of credit because he kept his word and he came through. So just enough of that. We honor students who have exceeded what's perceived as the average performer. And historically and traditionally, as you know, when you guys were in school, and I'm older, probably older than most of you here, they're called the salutatorian and salutatorian and valedictorian. And we have a tie with the salutatorian. I think this is the first time in my 12 years. Yes? And I want to welcome back Ms. Fisher. Many of you were students of Ms. Fisher. Although she's retired, she is working hourly, tutoring our kids, so it's great to have her back. And she keeps pointing out all the parents. That one was my student, and that one. So we'll start with the first salutatorian. Oh, I didn't know I was supposed to say the name at first. It's different this year. Okay. My name is Caden Clayton. I am 11 years old. I was born and raised in Miami, Florida. My parents are Caleb Clayton and Victoria Smith. I have been in the gifted program since kindergarten. That's amazing. And I am now graduating from elementary and moving on to middle school. My hobbies are gaming, fishing, football, and swimming. My future plans are becoming a robotic engineer in a computer program. Lots of money. All right. Now you can take care of your parents. While attending Brentwood Elementary, I met a lot of new people and made a lot of friends. At Brentwood, I learned new things that enhanced my learning skills. When I first started fifth grade, I was nervous and scared of what my fifth grade year would be like. But then it turned out to be a very good year. While attending middle school, I plan to take what I learned from Brentwood to further my education. Caden, did you write that yourself? That's impressive. And he's in control. He greets me every morning. So he's smart, good looking, and he's gonna be rich. Can't beat that. Our second salutatorian, the tie I mentioned. My name is Angeli Pena. I'm 11 years old. And I am in the fifth grade gifted program. When I finish college, I hope to have a PhD in math. Wow. She'll be taking a lot of statistics classes. Or I hope to be a lawyer. My interest in math has come from the help of Mrs. Vereen, Ms. Walker, Mrs. Lyles, Ms. Blanc, and Ms. Butterfield. The thing I'll miss the most at Brentwood are my friends and the teachers, which were my family away from home. I also thank my parents and my teachers for pushing me to be the best that I can be. That's nice. Very nice. Impressive again. Now, let's give a big hand of applause to the valedictorian and our salutatorian. Caden. Okay, now for our vow. My name is Corey Barnes Jr. Born on July 14th, oh cool, on July 1st, 2004 at 7:43 at North Shore Hospital. When I get older, I want to work for law enforcement in the canine unit. That's pretty cool. You have to be, that's a special area. That's nice. The people I look up to are in my family, my parents, aunts, uncles, and great-grandparents and grandparents. They show me that anything I put my mind to and focus on, I can accomplish. They show me that giving up should never be an option. They support each other. That's pretty nice, Corey. Corey, come up. Corey! Corey greets me in the morning as well. And now, last but not least, our turnaround student. As you know, we track our students as much as possible. This particular student has been here since kindergarten. I don't want to say pre-K, but I might be wrong. I believe kindergarten. And he's had many challenges. I got to know him really well when he was in second grade. And he was struggling in reading. He didn't like reading. He didn't like school. He had some behavior problems. He had fights and disrespect to adults. And I have to say, this year, he is definitely one of the turnaround guys. He's handsome. He's smart. His grades are where they need to be. He's polite and courteous. Every now and then, he might show a little attitude or antsy, but minimal. And I'm glad that the teachers have selected someone who started as a youngster here, although he still is, but a young youngster. And I'm thrilled for him, and he has no idea that he is the turnaround student. And I'm not sure if his mom is here, because I know she works during the day, and we didn't tell her. So let me just say, I just want to make sure I covered everything. This year, he has made an enormous effort to improve. He has made major improvements in both math and reading. And it was great. It is with great pleasure that I award Calvin Eddy.
Dr. Jackson, I'd like to introduce our assistant principal, Dr. Solomon Hamidis, with the privilege of presenting the awards to the Honor Roll student for 2015. The
names are as follows for honor roll four times. Eric Theo. Angelique Pina. Caden Clayton. Corey Barnes. Next we have Caden Clayton. That's it, thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Hamidis. Our program will continue with the presentation of the fifth grade teacher awards. Ms. Jones.
Good morning. Well, I've had the pleasure of having these four students for the past 2 to 3 years, and it's been a very good ride along. I'm going to truly miss each of you because you're like my own children. I wish you much success in your future endeavors. To begin with, we have gifted. Moving forward, this student is an all-around student, straight A1 A's, always helping, meeting me in the morning, want to bring everything that I'm struggling to come in with to help me out. And this trophy goes to Corey Barnes. Charts, we have Corey Barnes, Caden Clayton, and thank you, may I have a seat.
Congratulations to all the recipients. Our program will continue with Ms. Washington. The rest of the awards that I will be calling out, the students just please stand. My two all-star students are Michael Simon and Amari Hicks. Language Arts Awards, Michael Simon, DeAndre Corsino, Amari Hicks, and Vanessa Floriat. Faithful attendance, Amari Hicks, Dante Dixon, and Shamari Strigler. Academic achievement, Vanessa Floriat. Conduct awards, Shamaria Courtney, Michael Simon, and Tasia Armstrong.
Effort Award, Dante Dixon, Joel Prince, and Jose Clemente. And that concludes my award.
Wallace and Ms. Walker with their awards.
Okay, Ms. Walker and myself are going to be presenting for our classes. I'm the reading and language arts teacher, and Ms. Walker is the math and science. Okay, first I'm going to give the reading awards. When I Call You, Come Up, Please. Felicia Francis. Tyler Anderson. David Hilbert. Keith Bella. And Sanchez Denard. Language arts, these students just stand. Your certificates are upstairs. Emily Alexis, Destiny Green, Cheyenne Bethune, Shania Hill, Felicia Francis, and Janelle Joseph. Keith Bennett, Michael Simmons, Kenny Hilaire, and Dalen Hilbert. Okay, my two outstanding students are, please stand, Tashelle Jackson and Yasira Feliz. Perfect attendance, Kiana Brown, Kenitra Wright, Felicia Francis, Rashad Nichols. Faithful attendance, Destiny Green, Shania Hill, Giovanni Waswell. Academic achievement goes to Kamani Foster. Stay, come on. Stay. Three students who have showed improvement in conduct, Antoine Pendleton, James Shaw, Addison Bryant. And three students for effort, Andre Fields, Avari Marshall, and Shania Darbus.
This year, I don't know if you all know, but for fifth grade, math was a struggle for these kids. It was really, really, really hard. And I commend all of the students for giving it their best and trying to meet the standards that we have set for them. So for math, for my classes, Tyler Anderson, David Hilbert, Cheyenne Bethune. For science, Wayne Favors, Kenny Hilaire, Dalen Hilbert, Michael Simmons, Cheyenne Bethune. For the rest of the awards, students, please just stand. My outstanding students, Cheyenne Bethune, Michael Simmons. Perfect attendance, Kenny Hilaire. Faithful attendance, Khalid Bryant, Calvin Eddy, Rashayla Johnson. My academic achievement, I gave this young lady this award because with everything that was presented to her, when she did not understand what was going on, she tried, and she never gave up. And I give my academic achievement award to Ayanna Whitten. Conduct, Michael Simmons, Shania Pierre-Lewis,
Kamani Parks. Everett, Devin Smith, Kayla Thomas, Shania Pierre.
Now we want to acknowledge our very important parents. We'd like to acknowledge Bridget Davis, Darius Davis' mom, please come up. And Evelyn Elves, Cheyenne's grandmother. Okay, that's all for Walker and myself. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Now Ms. Ivy and Ms. Rain with their awards.
Good morning, everyone. I'm the reading teacher and Ms. Rain is the math and science teacher. My reading awards go to Anaya Abraham, Renee Owens, Sandra Lewis Pierre, Tyler Walters, Anaya Mojica, Sierra Johnson, Imani Stephanie, Eric Thea. Good job, guys. Language arts, please stand. I'll call your name. Anaya Abraham, Renee Owens, Tanasia Hall, Tyler Walters, Sonia Mojica, Michael Christian, Sierra Johnson, Imani Stephanie, and Eric Thea. All right, perfect attendance for my class. Angela Blair, Tyler Terrell Jackson, Dana Calderon, Rashawn Rainey, Darnell Dixon. Faithful attendance, Anaya Abraham, Sanaya Mojica, Lynette Ferguson, Renee Owens, Robin Jackson, and Akeem Belmo. Conduct, Leroy Brupton, Tamar Daniels, Damon Holden. Effort. These are the people that was not able to have A's and B's, but they tried their best. Demaya Thomas, Darnell Dixon, and Terrell Jackson. Sorry, my outstanding students are Anaya Abraham and Tyler Walters. Academic achievement student. He just started in the middle of the year, but he came right in and just fit in and did everything that we were doing, and he was outstanding. Jaquan Putman. My very important parent, Marion Bruton.
Good morning. Congratulations to all the boys and girls. You know, I have to make a little speech, just a short one. This is what I want you to remember when you get over to middle school. Great minds discuss ideas. Average minds discuss events. Small minds discuss people. When you leave and go to middle school, you're not there to talk about people, aggravate people, and stress people out. When you get there, I want you to talk about your ideas, talk about your dreams and your goals and your aspirations and how you will achieve them. Does everyone understand that? Okay. Now, for math, like Ms. Walker said, it was a challenging year. So awards go to Sierra Johnson, A&B all year, Eric Thea, Anaya Abrahams, and Tyler Walters. For science, Jamara Drayton, Eric Thea, Sierra Johnson, Imani Stepney, Donna Calderon, Tyler Walters, Renee Owens, and Anaya Abrahams. Congratulations. The remainder of the students, please just stand at your seat. Perfect attendance. Sierra Johnson. He's already up here. Faithful attendance. Michael Christian. Anel Dorval. LaDeldrick McGee. And Amari Fabian. Academic achievement. Michael Christian. Conduct, Bianca Bruton. Amari Fabian. Tamaya Pendleton. Effort, Iliani Martinez. Imani Atkins. And Precious Hayes. And my very important parent was also Miss Miriam Bruton, so I decided to choose a very important person that helped me survive the school year. I don't deal well with a lot of girl drama for some reason, but at lunchtime, it was a very important person, our security guard, Mr. Shasia. She sat and she counseled and she motivated and she mentored my girls. And it helped me survive the school year. I don't know if she's sitting there. Where's Miss DeShazia? She might be in PLC. But she is my very important person. And I love you guys. And congratulations. But I got to go.
Congratulations to all the recipients. The fifth grade class will now perform a musical selection.
Outstanding students, I apologize. Eric Thea, stand Eric, and Sierra Johnson.
Congratulations to all the recipients. The fifth grade class will now perform a musical selection.
Chapter ends. A new one now begins. The time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these years when we were here are in vain. For all of we
yourselves up. Yep, please come to the podium.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Aseli Misafiche. I have the honor to present a trophy and some medals to students with Seven Music Class throughout the year. If I can call you, please come forward. Let's start with the trophy. The recipient of a trophy is a student with the highest score in music class in every single marking period. He got a 4.0 average. The music trophy goes to Corey Barnes. Corey Jones class, congratulations, Corey. Now, the medals go from Ms. Gonzalez class, please come forward. Cheyenne Bethune, Kiana Brown, Alison Bryant, Destiny Green, Shania Hill, Janet Joseph, Angeli Pena, and Demetra Wright. From Ms. Verin's class, Michael Christian, Yamara Drechen, Sierra Johnson, Imani Stephanie. From his Walker class, Tyler Anderson, Kenny Heller, Megan Hilbert, Rachela Johnson, and Kayla Thomas. Okay, from Miss Ivy class, Anaya Abraham, Jayden Jackson, Robin Jackson, Sandra McQueen, and Tyler Waters. No, sorry, and Brene Owens too. And from Miss Young Gifted Students, Kaden Clayton. Congratulations to all the fifth graders and best wishes. Thank you.
Now with now Mr. Dances with the Art Awards.
Superior achievement, which means consistent straight A's, but also consistent with behavior, attitude, every single day. And not only that, but they also had talent, for a great talent and all. The award goes to Tyler Walton. Simmons, Kenny Hilaire. From Ms. Ivy's class, Angela Blair, Amaya Thomas, Brene Owens, and Leroy Rubin. From Ms. Gonzalez's class, Angela Pena, Destiny Green, Shania Hill, and Avari Marshall. Sierra Johnson, Tamaya Pendleton, Michael Christian, and Fabian Amara. And from Ms. Jones' class, Katie Clayton, I think I called her. Katie Clayton, and Corey Barnes. And that concludes the awards for her.
Thank you.
Now Ms. Velasco with the Spanish awards.
The trophy goes to Corey Barnes.
Select these six students for their trophies. Not only did she give these awards due to students who were athletic, she also gave the awards based on sportsmanship and their attitude and their behavior in PE. It's very important, boys and girls, that even though you are very athletic, you understand that having good sportsmanship is very important. If you're a sore loser and you're always upset, then people are gonna see that instead of seeing how athletic you are. They're gonna remember how you act and how you behave instead of the great things that you can accomplish. Okay, my six, Miss Bethel's six trophies go to Corey Barnes, Kenita Wright, Michael Christian, Michael Simon, Pedro Rodriguez, and Michael Simmons. Good girl, Kenitra. Okay, now she has medals. She wanted to acknowledge certain students. Please come up when I call you. Destiny Green, Angelique Peña, Giovanni Roswell, Eliani Martinez, John McDermott, Cheyenne Bethune, Darius Davis, Avari Marshall, Vanessa Fluitt, Calvin Eddy, Bianca Bruton, Kimani Parks, Leroy Bruton, Caden Payton, Kevette Daniels, Demaya Thomas, Terrell Jackson, Damian Holder, Keith Bellet, and DeAndre Corsino. Thank you, boys and girls. Congratulations to all the students who have earned these special area awards. And now we will continue with the presentation of the Brentwood Club Awards. Ms. Colmar, please come to the podium.
Hi, everybody. It's nice to see so many familiar faces. I have an announcement. There are some reading materials for student practice over the summer. If you would like these free materials, they're on the table right beside the stairwell. So before you leave, help yourselves. Thank you. Okay. Brentwood, this year we have a program, a technology program called iReady. How many of you know that program at home? Okay. Well, this is a program that supports reading and math, and we wanted to recognize the children in math. I want to call your names. Come on up. In Ms. Vereen's class, the highest pass rate goes to Precious Hayes. And in her PM class, Corey Barnes. In Ms. Walker's AM class, Michael Simmons. And in her PM class, Cheyenne Bethune. And in Ms. Washington's class, Shamari Strigler. That's the passing grade. Now we have in the classes the games from the beginning of the school year to the end of the school year. These kids are going to get certificates. Third highest game, Ms. Washington, goes to Michael Simon. Second highest game, DeAndre Corsino. And the highest game is Shamari Strigler. The highest game. In Ms. Vereen's class, highest game, third highest game, Damani Atkins. Second highest game, Eric Seoff. And the medal goes to the highest game, Eliani Martinez. Ms. Ivy, or actually Ms. Vereen, PM class. Third highest goes to Brene Owens. Second highest, Darian Anderson. And the medal goes for highest gains, Tyla Walters. And Ms. Walker, third highest gain, Calvin Eddy. Second highest, Tyler Unique Anderson. And the Kenny Hilaire. And in Ms. Gonzalez, also Ms. Walker's math class. Third highest, Antoine Pendleton. Second highest, Allison Bryant. Dancing Club. And the recipients of this are Michael Spindon, Corey Wu, Corey Barn, Kaden Clayton, and Andre Theo. We also have the Science Fair. Dr. Hamida sponsored it this year, but it's very near and dear to my heart. So, thank you guys for Stella for Chester. In third place, from Ms. Walker's class, is Tyler Anderson for the Science Fair. In second place, Ms. Walker's science class, Michael Simmons. And first place for the science fair, from Ms. Marie's class, Michael Christian. One is called ESAC, the other is called PTA. ESAC stands for School Advisory Council, and it is made up of a committee of parents, mostly parents, a few teachers, administrators, and two students. We meet approximately 4 or 5 times a year, and the sole purpose of the ESAC is for school improvement for your children. If you have children that are still at Brentwood next year, please become active in our ESAC. We need you desperately. So let me go ahead and award these special parents, Miss Regina Farrington. Please come on up as our ESAC representative. And our little helper is Destiny Green as our student representative. You know the name PTA. It stands for Parent Teacher Association. We are almost 800 children strong in our building, and we have about 3 or 4 PTA parents in the whole building. Again, if you have children here next year, we need you. We're looking for officers. Please, please support PTA. Get involved in your children's education. It takes a village. Without further ado, I'd like to recognize PTA, Miss Bridget Davis.
Sorry, I have an announcement. We have a car blocking another vehicle and they need to leave. It's an emergency. It's a silver Moreno truck. Please move so that the person you're blocking can leave. It's gonna be towed if you don't move it.
That's okay, let's re-announce that. Miss Bridget Davis for active participation in PTA. Yay!
Good morning, parents. I know I'm not on the program, but as a representative of the PTA, do you feel it was an honor and a privilege for your children to get all these medals? Aren't those medals beautiful and all those trophies Corey Barnes got this morning? I'd just like to let you know that that was sponsored by the PTA. So we want you to please actively, not here at Brentwood, at the middle school, they have PTA as well. Please get involved in your child's PTA association.
We're not going to leave out PTA Regina Farrington. And Evelyn Epps. Ms. Epps, are you here? Thank you. Come on down. Okay, we had a very exciting event happen a few weeks ago. It was called the Brentwood Spelling Bee. And it was, I've been doing the Spelling Bee for like about 30 years, and this was really exciting for me to watch this. We ran out of words. They spelled so well, we ran out of words. So, we had to go to round two. It gives me great pleasure to announce the first runner up was Khalid Bryant. Come on down. This is amazing. And the winner goes to Janelle Johnson. Spelling Bee was last night. The co-winners took home $38,000. Yeah, but you know what? A football player takes home $138 million. Academic? Sports? I don't know. Right? Well done. And then we have one last special award. This goes to a volunteer in our school who comes every single day, 8 o'clock to 4 o'clock, and she is a volunteer. What did I say? A volunteer every single day for your children. Her name is Miss Marilyn Clark.
Washington's class,
Omari Hicks with 95%. And in Ms. Jones' class, Corey Hu with 89%. We also are recognizing the highest growth rate in Ms. Gonzalez, and that means from growing from the November to May. A.M. James Shaw, 99 points. P.M. Caleb Bryant at 152 points. In Ms. Ivy, Ishmael Armstrong, 121 points. P.M. class, Tanisha Hall, 70 points. Ms. Jones class, Corey Barnes, 41 points. And Ms. Washington's class, Dante Dixon, 58 points. In addition, for iReady, we had a quiz pass rate. A.M. Gonzalez's class, Felixia Francis, and in her P.M. class, Darius Davis. In Ms. Ivy's class, A.M. Eric Theop, P.M. Tamar Daniels. In Ms. Jones' class, Corey Barnes, and in Ms. Washington's class, Michael Simon. I'd like to ask Dr. Hamidas to come up for the 5,000. Okay.
All right, we would like to take this time to congratulate all of our 5,000 role models. This is a brand new program to Brentwood. Although it's not a new program, however, it's a brand new program to Brentwood Elementary this school year. And these guys have worked very, very hard, and we're proud of them. We're going to go ahead and start with our leaders. In order to receive, we had a number of leaders. However, in order to receive an award, you would have to have great attendance, for the most part. All right, so the first person we're going to, who's our communication director, is Mr. Kevin Smith. Come up, Kevin Smith. I always get him and Devin confused. Okay, come right here. Our next person, this person, I've already told him before that I'm really, really proud of him. I felt like he made a very, a great impact this year. You know, he's a student that when I used to see him last year, he was always getting the stuff. However, he's done a great turnaround. He knows who he is. Mr. Darian Anderson. He is our sergeant of honor. He does a well job doing that. Also, our vice president, okay, Mr. Caden Clayton. These guys are true born leaders. And of course, our president is Mr. Corey Barnes. Awesome. Now, we're going to go ahead and announce the members. However, we did have some students who previously joined. We're not going to announce them because they weren't in the program all school year long. We're only going to talk to those who are in the program since the end of school year for the most part. Okay, when I call you, please come up. Wayne Favors, Rashawn Rainey, Keith Bella, Derek Hill, Rashad Nicholas, Kenny Hilaire, Tyler Unique Anderson, Leroy Bruton III, Michael Simmons, Daniel Bullard, Devin Smith, Akeem Vollmar, Khalid, he's another name I always mess up. Khalid. Okay, I said it right today. Khalid Bryant, Darius Davis, John James, Damon Hilbert, Robert Ramos, Ladelric McGee, This is another name, Tomar. Tamar. Tamar Daniels, Damian Holder, Adonis Adobe, Michael Christian, John McDermott, Eric Theo, Avari Marshall, DeAndre Casino, Andre Field, Perry Duhart, Darnell Dixon, James Shaw, and Giovanni Russell. Listen, let's give them, because let me tell you something. Believe it or not, a lot of our African-American males and, of course, Latinos, as they progress, those who are struggling in school, they tend to drop out at a certain point. So this program, we want to help these students not drop out. We hope parents that even as they go through middle school and high school, they will remain in the program. They do offer scholarships and so forth. So we just want to congratulate these guys, encourage these fellas. And also, we have some new members. You don't have to come up here, but could you just please stand? Those who just recently joined, if you would just please stand. All the new members. All right, we would like to congratulate everybody. Show your sign. 5,000 role models. 5,000 role models. Thank you.
Wait, boys, stay. Boys, stay for a minute.
Good morning, parents, teachers, peers, and fellow fathers and role models. My name is Corey Barnes, and I have been an Arkansas City as your president for the 2014 to 2015 school year. I'd like to start off by thanking Dr. Hermitas, Mr. Dantis, Mr. Holt, and Mr. Blunt for taking the time out to show us how to become young men, for teaching us the importance of being respectful, having good hygiene, gun safety, and bullying, just to name a few. I hope that as we all move forward, we remember these things and encourage our peers to make the right decisions in life. This has been a great experience, so in closing, I would like to thank you. I would thank our wonderful leaders and amazing role models for making this year successful. Wish everyone the best of luck moving forward.
Trusted and loved each other and vowed not to let each other down. I'm not a stand in front of the podium type of guy and give a speech, but I felt I let my guys down if I didn't come with this. This being said, I'd like to congratulate the fifth graders who were on the basketball team this year, so clap it up for these guys. I gave the gentlemen an opportunity to give them all their own selves a nickname, so please clap it up for them and you will hear them in their nicknames. Darius, Big Daddy, and
yo!
Corey, the Professor Bones. Daniel, the Chief other. Michael Pops Christian. DeAndre the Afro Professor. Wayne Lil Weezy Favor. AKA Mr. Prom King. Avari the Wolf Marshall. LeDeldrick the Candyman McGee. John J.J. McDermott. Rashad Papa Smurf Nichols. And Rashawn, the boss, boss, the boss, man. Can I do that one more time for you guys?
Thank you, club sponsors. Now Ms. Fisher with the Dr. Samuel Stinson Award.
Good morning, parents, teachers, and graduating class of 2015. Dr. Samuel Stinson was born January 20th, 1943 in Garland, Alabama. He got his Bachelor of Science in Education in 1967, and he began a career in education at his high school alma mater, teaching English and literature. His career in Florida began in 1968, and he taught at Alapata and Shenandoah Middle, then he went on to be an assistant principal at Richmond and Glades Middle. Later, he was appointed principal at Brentwood Elementary. During his years at Brentwood, his motto was, "Brentwood Elementary has adopted the posture that all children will achieve," and he really believed it. He was so concerned about the children that he started an indoor swimming pool when there were a few deaths in this community, Miami Gardens. We were the first school to have swimming classes to begin so children would be safe. He served at Brentwood for 14 years. He retired June 2003. Unfortunately, Dr. Stinson died February 1st, 2013 at the age of 70. Several Brentwood Elementary staff got together and created the Dr. Samuel J. Stinson Fund in his honor as an educator and caring human being. Today, I am so proud to present an award to an individual who began at Brentwood 1985 to 1991. Her name is Tramiel Dillard. She is the manager of Miami's newest sensational gospel artist, Prosperity Four. She's a native of Miami Gardens and a Brentwood Elementary alumni who continues to reach back with many efforts to give back to the community. Growing up in what was then Carroll City, she learned early in life that she was destined to become a success, and she is. She earned her Bachelor's of Science in Health from the University of Florida, her Master's from Florida International University, and she's a candidate to receive her PhD in Public Health from Walden University. She has always believed that through books and believing in a force higher than she equals living a prosperous life. Over the years, Tramiel has received several awards and accolades, including being crowned Miami Carroll City her senior year. She's a well-known orator who speaks at many engagements and events such as these. We're very proud to say that she is one of our own. She is here to get the award. She is a twin. Her twin brother, Tramar Dillard, also known as Flo Rida, also attended Brentwood. Unfortunately, Tramar is at the airport as we speak on his way to one of his shows all over the country he goes. So I would like to present the Dr. Stinson Award to a beautiful young lady, Tramiel Duke. Now, Tramiel started a group with her sisters who also went to Brentwood called Prosperity Four. They are here to perform. They are a contemporary gospel group consisting of four anointed sisters who love to sing. They're based in Miami, and the four anointed sisters have been afforded countless opportunities to showcase their gifts in Miami Gardens. So I would like these women to come up, and they're going to perform a song for the graduating class in honor of you all achieving so much. They're a contemporary gospel group, and their single is out now. It's called Can't Take My Praise, and it's a worship in their relationship with God. You can enjoy this, and then you can talk to them after, and then we'll finish the ceremony. So here come Prosperity Four. Let's give them a hand. He's the only boy in the family. And here are the sisters. They all went to Brentwood from 1985 to 1991. He's the founder of Big Dreams for Kids, a nonprofit organization focused on assisting families and youngsters in need right here in Miami Gardens. With his mother, Ernestine, and his seven older sisters, right there, a few, failure was not an option for him. He is loved all over the world, and he's received the key to the city of Miami Gardens and Fort Lauderdale because of his commitment to service and dedication. So he will be coming back to this school to visit. So I hope you enjoyed that.
Thank you. have it out there, can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end. And suddenly it's like women and men will pass peace.